Join us as we follow Jesus into the pain and suffering of the people of the Ukraine. We're going to give you a number of opportunities that you can do just that, right from your own home, or you can get directly involved. Joining me is my grandson, Chris Aaron. And Chris, you're planning to take a trip, aren't you? Tell them about that trip.
Yeah, so we, as New Life, see the suffering and hurting of displaced refugees. There are over 5 million who have left the country, over 11 or 12 million now who are internally displaced. That's over a quarter of the population that have had to flee their homes, their livelihoods, everything that they've ever known because of this brutal, horrible war caused by Putin and his group of mad men who just have no moral ground. They have no empathy for the lives that they're tearing apart. And so New Life wants to be right there in the midst of the suffering to help local church bodies who are every single day supplying food, medical supplies, and transportation to refugees inside Ukraine.
Okay, that's in Ukraine. You've got three churches already, okay, lined up that you work with that have a lot of refugees. Mm-hmm. So you're going to go there, you're going to interact with those three churches. Then you're going to meet individuals that are going to maybe come to this country that are refugees from the Ukraine. Mm-hmm. And we're also building, well, actually rehabbing houses that are being made available to us for them when they come over here. Now, yeah. We have a work day that's coming up. Mm-hmm. And what day is that?
May 21st.
Okay, May 21st. It's coming up on that Saturday, right around the corner, like about a week from now. May 21st. And they're going to be doing work in there at that particular time. Mm-hmm. We still need to raise some $5,000 prior to the 1st of June. The reason being is because you want to take $1,000 to give to each one of the three churches and then mm-hmm. also have monies that you can directly help the refugees when, mm-hmm. once you get there. Yeah. We're going to see a lot of video when you return, a lot mm-hmm. of pictures, a lot of stuff, aren't you?
Yeah, we really want to be able to share the amazing things that God is doing through your support of New Life in Ukraine. We also want to build firmer relationships with these local church bodies and seek God's will in potential long-term missions like what we have in India, what we've established in Africa and Haiti. And so New Life is really being moved by the Holy Spirit to walk through these open doors that God is leading us in.
Yes,
and we want to be faithful with the resources that we have and that you graciously provide. And so anything that we do in Ukraine is because of our wonderful partners like you who see on the news all the different things that are going on in Ukraine. And maybe you felt like, I don't really have an ability to help. Well, New Life is wanting to provide you, to facilitate a chance for you to really make a big difference in the lives of Ukrainians who are suffering from this war by supporting this trip, by helping sponsor a family as they come over, or by volunteering some of your talents or your skills or time to come and help fix up these houses as we prepare for these parolees as they come from Ukraine.
Okay, how can people get in touch with you? You have an email address. They can email you directly. They can call you. Go ahead and give them some addresses.
Yeah, so please email me at carice@nlecstl.org. carice@nlecstl.org. Or call me at 314-887-8113. 314-887-8113.
Chris Aaron, the people of Ukraine have shown tremendous courage. Mm-hmm. I just heard a few minutes ago, like a stanza out of the Ukraine national anthem. And I was really touched. I want to touch on that. In fact, I'm going to play, they're going to hear it in Ukraine people for a little over a minute, you know. I saw this and I was just really touched. I thought about what Ukraine was, you know, when they first sang this, and I look at the bombed out part of it now, but brave and glorious spirit of Ukraine. I'm going to let people know a little in English what they're hearing on their training. Through centuries, stay ignited. Blessed by longing for our liberty, we shall stand united. Like the morning dew and rays of sunshine, our foes will vanish. Brothers together, we lead on, prosper in the land we cherish. We'll lay down our body and soul. We see him doing this. For the freedom of our nation, we'll prove that we are people of the Cossack generation. I mean, a powerful national anthem, and the people are living this out and are dying in massive numbers.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. So Ukraine is a very proud nation in the sense that they are unified under this one kind of ethnicity, this Cossack nation, and it comes from their rooted history of strength and unity and this pursuit of freedom, this real pursuit of freedom. And, you know, Ukraine is really not that old of a country. 1992 is the first time that they really won independence since before World War II. And so they are clinging to their identity, and this war has only made them stronger as a nation as they've united under some common values that you and I kind of take for granted. The right to liberty, the right to property, the right to freedom to express your own ideas. And so this war has really been spun as a war of democracy against autocracy, right? And we are seeing the world, not just Russia and Ukraine, kind of side with those two nations. One thing we don't really read about in the news is all of the different countries that support Russia or who won't come out against Russia and condemn their work. There are a number of countries in Africa, because Africa receives so many resources from Russia, they feel pressured not to condemn their work in Ukraine. And so this is really a global war. This isn't just between Ukraine and Russia. And I've been saying all the time, you know, depending on how Russia moves here in Ukraine, we could be seeing the pretext for a much more global war.
Okay, we're going to take a moment, and I want people to hear this in the Ukrainian language. I want to visualize what this country was like, the country of Ukraine, prior to Putin's war, when he came and started bombing, I mean, building after building, including hospitals and all different kinds of things. And why so many people feel so strong about this, and how we have to stand up and help these individuals. Then we're going to come back after you hear just a little bit of that national anthem, and you're going to be given some more practical ways that you can directly get involved. So be a part of what God is doing at this particular hour.
Ні слава, ні воля, ще нам, браття українці, усміхнеться доля, згинуть наші вороженьки, як роса на сонці.
Maybe you didn't catch what I shared earlier about how we need to follow Jesus into the pain and suffering of the Ukrainian people. Now, for 50 years, New Life Evangelistic Center has been striving to follow Jesus into the pain and suffering of the homeless in mid-America. We've shared with you story after story concerning that in India, Africa, Haiti, and now into the Ukraine. And there's practical ways that you can get directly involved. And Chris here in a moment is going to go into more detail on that. But we've mentioned you could have your church actually adopt a church in Ukraine. He's been doing Zoom meetings with different churches in the Ukraine. And they're getting many, many refugees that are coming. And this is all in the western part of the country. That's one way you could get involved. You can help sponsor a actual family that comes from the Ukraine. We can talk about that more. And you can come out and be a part of our next work day. We had a glorious one already. So many people came out, and they got so much work done in that day. But we need some more work done in this house on Marvin Street. Now, if you can't do that, You can donate your money for the, so we can get the materials so people can actually do the work in your behalf. And you can send that gift to New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 62166. Clearly label it for the Ukraine outreach. Label it for Ukraine refugees. Just designate it if that's what you want used in that area. We'll use it. You don't need to send me any kind of letter. I got one like this from somebody or an email. Well, what are you helping those people over there for? We got so many people here that are in need. We've been doing that for 50 years. We're helping. But Jesus, and I take you back to the Bible, said we're supposed to be his witness in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and the uttermost parts of the earth. So yes, most of our work is done right here in mid-America. But we don't want to forget the people that are there. We still need $5,000 prior to the first part of June, so that we can directly help the churches that are there, the refugees that are there, and that's for the trip. But we also need some money for things that we need to do right here on the house on Marvin. And again, we need some volunteers to come out and help. And what are some of the things you need volunteers for at that house that we're fixing up for the Ukrainian family?
Yeah, so this next workday is going to be a little bit more technical than the last one. We had a lot of demo and yard work that we were able to do, and it was so great to see those groups come out and really support Ukrainians by working on this house. This next time, we're looking at doing some actual remodel of the house and walking through making some repairs that are needed to be made in the house. And so we definitely need those tax-deductible gifts to buy the supplies necessary to, and if you are able and are talented, God's gifted you with some skills to do remodels on houses. We really need you there to help put your skills, into this house. And just imagine being a physical, element of providing safety, security, and community to women and children as they're fleeing a war-torn country. You can make that impact by coming on May 21st. We're going to be there from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. And Lord willing, the weather's going to be good, and we're just going to be able to get so much done while we're in fellowship together and making this house a suitable place to live for fleeing women
we
and children.
We need plumbers, electricians, carpenters.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, give me your email address again and your number.
Yeah, so please email me at carice@nlecstl.org or call me at 314-887-8113. This is a really tangible way to help the Ukrainian community here in the United States. Housing is such a hard thing to find, but we know these refugees are going to be coming, and if they get here and we don't have the houses prepared, it's going to make it really difficult to help them transition into this new life here in St. Louis.
Those that are coming are primarily women, children, and people over 60 years of age. The men are having to stay in that country and fight.
That's
so
right.
These women are having to leave their husbands, children having to leave their family, fathers, come to this particular country, and they're referring them to them right now as parolees. What's a parolee versus, say, somebody's coming to stay?
That is a complex question, but to simplify it, a parolee doesn't have as many rights as a refugee when they first come. People are invited to apply for authorization to work and all of these other things, but to be a parolee just means that there's something happening in your home country that doesn't allow you to stay there, and you're fleeing to the United States. And so that's kind of the umbrella term that they use. Refugees have a few more rights, and it's a little easier to immigrate if you're a refugee.
Okay, now, so we may have a lot of these parolees come over.
Mm-hmm.
They need a place to stay. We're letting people stay in the house like 6 months.
Mm-hmm.
If they decide to want to go back to the country, they can go back. If they decide that they want to stay here, you know, and they apply for refugee status, then they start paying a little bit every month. Hopefully they got a job by then, and we can actually apply it to whatever the cost is in that house, and they can end up becoming homeowners that way.
Mm-hmm.
But we also need houses at this particular time. People may have houses that they just aren't physically able to go out and do all this work like our volunteers could be doing. And every year they just leave it there, and they hope they sell it, and it just goes down further, further, further. If they just turn loose and put in the hands of Jesus, just say, "Here, Lord, you give it to me. I want to donate to New Life Evangelistic Center." They could get total tax credit. Sometimes that's as much, if not more, than what they could sell it for, okay? Total tax credit. know that what they're doing, they can't take it with them when they die. And so and they're getting it in the hands of the work of the Lord. We can get these teams together, and teams that can work until the work is done. They can come out and work for the glory of God. People may not be able to do that, but they could donate a house. That'd be great if you got an email from somebody that says, I want to donate a house.
Absolutely.
Or a call from somebody who says, I'd like to give you a house.
Yeah, absolutely.
Give them the address again and the phone number.
Yeah, so please email me at carice@nlecstl.org or give me a call at 314-887-8113. I'd love to talk about this specific homesteading program that we've got here. There are also other ways that you can really help. As we look at the open door to do long-term missions in Ukraine, I would love for you to be a prayer warrior with me, daily praying for our team as we go into this active war zone to minister to the refugees in their place. We know that this war has destroyed so much infrastructure and that for years this country is going to be rebuilding. So New Life is prayerfully seeking God's will about building potentially an orphanage or some kind of shelter to help refugees as they're coming back to their country to rebuild. What a wonderful way to do ministry and to preach the gospel. And so we're just really seeking God's will in that. Please pray for us as we seek how to do long-term missions in Ukraine and develop these very important relationships with local churches there.
Now, you can work with us till the work is done. You can join us in following Jesus into the pain and suffering of the people in the Ukraine by, at this time, praying for the work of New Life Evangelistic Center, sending your tax-deductible gift to P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. You can give online at nlecstl.org. You can come out and work on the work day. You can get your church involved, and they can actually sponsor our fellowship, our partner with the church in the Ukraine at this particular time, whereas your church got more and more involved, we could work it out where he'd be able to have regular meetings and back and forth via Zoom with the pastor that's there. So many opportunities. But brothers and sisters, it's time for us to get off the couch and work till the work is done. Fall on your knees. Pray for this work. We need your help right now.
Joyful in the service of the kingdom, or has serving Jesus slowly lost its charm? Folded hands and hardened hearts can't fly to glory when Gabriel's trumpet sounds the last alarm. Occupy till I come, see that the work is done.
Labor in the vineyard, faithful ones.
Be the sheep, help me, be my hands and my feet. See that the work is done, occupied till I come.
We must be about the Father's business, leading lost and lonely souls to Christ. Will he find us faithful, loyal, loving servants who made the most of what we had in life?
Occupied till I come, see that the work is done.
Labor in the vineyard, faithful ones.
Be the sheep, help the weak, be my hands and my feet. See that the work is done. Labor in the vineyard, faithful ones. Be the sheep, help the weak. Be my hands and my feet. See that the work is done. Occupied till I come. See that the work is done. We'll work till Jesus comes. Jesus comes, we come.
Yes, you can work till the work is done. We've given you so many opportunities. You can be a prayer warrior. Let us know that you're doing that. We need people that will donate right now. $5,000 needed immediately by the 1st of June so that Chris Aaron can go and help these churches that are actually in Ukraine right now. They don't know what the futures hold, but they know who holds the futures. Jesus. You can get a hold of your pastor and say, Pastor, you know, St. Louis used to have sister cities. Why don't we have a sister church in Ukraine? Why don't you share that vision with your pastor? Where there's no vision, the people perish. I know there's a lot of churches that are fixing up shoeboxes and other things, and they're shipping stuff over. And that's all needed in Poland. But we're talking about taking you behind the lines right into the country of Ukraine where you can have a sister church if you'll just get up and get involved and work till the work is done and get in touch with Chris Aaron. You can actually start fixing up a home right now for a Ukrainian family. And you'd be able to minister to them and incorporate, get them into your church life. And just be able to move. You can sponsor a family coming from the Ukraine. And we're giving you all those opportunities, and that's why we have him keep giving out his email address and phone number. Let's do it again.
Yeah, so please email me about any of these things that, as the Spirit leads you to give at this time, there's so many ways for you to give. And reach out to me at carice@nlecstl.org. And my number is 314-887-8113. And I'd love to connect with you, connect with your church. If you think it's appropriate, I'd love to come and speak and share the work that New Life Evangelistic Center is doing in the Ukraine. Again, we see on the news so many horrible things that are taking place. And we try to imagine just how scared and how horrified people are in that country. But imagine being the hand of Christ for that family. Imagine tangibly stepping into the brokenness, the suffering, the hurt, the pain, and wrapping them in your arms. You can do that when you partner with New Life Evangelistic Center. Because we have always sought to be on the front lines, to be there when people are hurting. And we see Ukraine, and we see how horrible this war is, and how much destruction and evil is taking place. You can be a part of the change.
Please, let the Holy Spirit speak through you. This is a tremendous opportunity. I don't know anyone else that's offering it. It's being offered to you now. How your church can get directly involved. More than just a mission program somewhere. It's directly linking with a pastor in the western part of the Ukraine at the present time, where so many of the refugees are fleeing. Yes, maybe 6 million have left the country, but millions more are just moving around in the country. And they don't know when that's going to be. The western area could get bombed at any time, too. It's happened, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has. Some of the cities that I will be visiting have been actively bombed. So again, pray that I am safe.
Going with your wife or going with your daughter?
Yes, pray that my family is safe as we go to minister to hurting people. Some of the churches that we will be helping are directly involved in helping people transport from the east to the west. And this is amazing ministry as they take vans and just drive out into the middle of a war zone to pick up people who are disabled, people who don't have the funds to try and move themselves. What an amazing way to help a church that's actively involved in this kind of work, saving lives by pulling people out of destroyed cities. You can be involved in a church like that by partnering with New Life Evangelistic Center.
Last Monday, I met with your mother, your father, and your other grandfather, Aaron Rothinger, okay? And your mother was there, and somehow the conversation got about, wow, they're going over there. And I said, yes, people shouldn't be surprised. He's got a lot of R&R in him. He's got Rice and Rothinger. Your other grandfather took your mother when she was a little child, and his wife and the other children, to Vietnam in the middle of the Vietnam War and did missionary work, okay? And so when we've been working in the intercities and different other things on this end, so here you got two grandfathers that have been very much involved in different aspects of it. And so it's quite natural now, I guess, for you to go right in the middle of that war zone.
You know, what I would say is that when you understand that it is the will of God to counsel and minister to suffering people, and the door opens for you in faith, You take as much precaution as you can. But in faith, there's no fear. There's no fear of being taken or being wounded, because I know that I'm in the sovereign hands of a good God who is mighty. And no matter what happens to me or my family in that country, we're doing His will. And that's the safest place to be. And so that's my source of faith and hope. I'm not concerned for my own safety, but I appreciate your prayers and your concern. I've had many people personally say, well, we're praying for you. I appreciate that so much. And please continue to do that as we do look at stepping into a dangerous place to really minister to hurting people. We know, and even in the Bible, it expresses that when we are going through pain and suffering, we are at the critical moment to hear the gospel. We're ready to hear the gospel because the gospel is so real, life-changing, when we experience that pain and suffering.
Amen. And we're giving you an opportunity. You are able to go with him to the Ukraine through sharing those tax-deductible gifts. $5,000 is needed. And you're going to be leaving June the 11th, so we need it before that. You're going to be till there, what, to 28th, 29th?
Yeah, we haven't actually shared the dates. We are leaving June 11th, and we'll be coming back the 28th, but I'll be back here in St. Louis on the 29th.
Your brother-in-law is going to be a guide for you. He's Ukrainian.
Yeah.
Running you all over, introducing you to everybody for two solid weeks of work.
Yes, so my brother-in-law will be translating with me and traveling, Lord willing, and we'll be arriving in Warsaw, and we'll have to take a bus into Ukraine because there are no flights directly into Ukraine. And then once we're in Ukraine, we're going to be visiting the city of Lutsk and the city of Lviv, which are two major cities where refugees have congregated. Lutsk receives a lot of refugees, but then sends them on. Lviv is where many of those internal refugees are staying, and there are actually kind of like pop-up shelters that have been put up by the government. We plan to go and visit those and actually talk with some of the refugees, hear their testimonies, hear how we can help them most, explain our programming here in the homesteading program, and seek how we can build a system with these churches to try and help sponsor families to get out of those dangerous zones.
Well, thank you, Chris Aaron. And please, folks, pray for Chris Aaron, his wife Irene, their little 1-2-year-old Abby, and please continue to pray for the work of the New Life Evangelistic Center. And again, you can join us in following Jesus into the middle of the pain and suffering in Ukraine by sharing your gift also either online at nlecstl.org or P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. You can put Ukraine in the lower left-hand corner of your check. You include a note, but you can make such a big difference for good by sharing now, getting directly involved. Please continue to pray for the work of New Life Evangelistic Center as we're working to be there when people are hurting. Thank you for your prayers and faithful partnership.